National Identification and Registration Authority yesterday, 5th June, announced postponement of the date for the renewal of the National Identification Cards till the end of July. According to Rosemary Kisembo, the National Identification and Registration Authority Executive Director, there has been a delay in delivery of equipment that facilitates the exercise, therefore prompting the extension of the due date.
The mass enrollment and renewal exercise was set to start on 1st June 2024. However, due to unforeseen delays in the procurement process, the exercise did not take off. Nevertheless, by the end of July 2024, the exercise will commence.
Issuance of national IDs commenced in the year 2014. After 10 years, the IDs are due to expire this year. According to NIRA, the new national IDs will bear improved unique security features to prevent faking.
Government is taking all necessary measures to ensure that the delays do not affect or impact service delivery.
NIRA says all efforts are underway to ensure that national IDs are issued in time because they're essential documents for the 2026 elections.
On behalf of the President of the Republic of Uganda, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, allow me to take this opportunity to commission Namagumba, Budadiri, Narugugu Road for upgrade.
Yesterday, the Prime Minister of the Republic of Uganda commissioned the upgrade of the Namagumba Naluguru Budadiri Road. The long-awaited flag off of this project comes at a time when residents in Sironko District have relentlessly pursued government for the upgrade of this road for decades. To many, this project is a relief to the communities in Sironko. The Prime Minister, Robinah Nabbanja, has emphasized to the contractors to ensure that quality standards are met as agreed in the contract. She urged the community to cooperate and take good care of the road after completion. The woman member of parliament for Sironko District, Honorable Nambose Florence, alongside other leaders in Sironko District, have thanked government for the timely intervention, noting that it has been a challenge for farmers to move their produce to the marketplaces because of the bad road infrastructure.
This is a very fertile place. Transport, bad terrain has been our biggest challenge. We are so excited as people from Masabaland that finally this to be constructed.
The road construction is being undertaken by the Ugandan National Roads Authority, UNRA. The so-called Jerusalem Day Flag March commemorates the Israel Army's capture in the 1967 Arab-Israel War of the city's eastern sector, home to the Al-Aqsa Mosque compound, Islam's third holiest site, which Jews call the Temple Mount. Thousands of mainly religious nationalists walk through predominantly Arab neighborhoods of the old city, waving Israel national flags, dancing, and occasionally shouting inflammatory or racist slogans. Police set up barriers near the Damascus Gate after announcing plans to deploy more than 3,000 officers during the day, an AFP correspondent reported. Most shops in the old city were closed before the march started as streets slowly emptied by of Palestinians and filled with young Israelis, some of whom carried weapons. Young people waving large Israel flags and chanting, "The people of Israel live," were seen near Jaffa Gate, and some wore t-shirts reading, "My land, I do not want to divide it." Police typically forced the closure of Palestinian businesses near the march route and kept Palestinians' residents away.